All right, we are on a quest for the spinner, and that means that we need to move a robot repair kit. Do we think this pops open and spills its contents? It's looking pretty solid at the moment. All right, I guess we'll learn the hard way. I think we're gonna go with our standard grabber here, I think. Because it seems like this is pretty easy to grab, and then we can easily center it on the back of our wheelbase. Let's see. Do that. Expand you. Contract you. Rotate that so that it's over our body. All right, easy peasy. And now we just have to fly. Famous last words. Just want to get our nose up a little bit. There we go. Uh-oh. We are not gaining enough altitude. All right, all's well. All's well that ends well. All right, now we're cruising. We're losing height. Good luck, Pallone. Good luck. There's lots of good folks in the Discord to, if you have questions, don't hesitate to ask. We're gonna need to relaunch on that one. All right, now we have a good, solid trajectory. So I think this just has a lot of weight to it. And also I think we just want to be, do we have this? Oops, that was the wrong one. Oh, I love the way that. Okay, we have this radio tower, so we don't need to hit it. Altitude, please. Oof. Kind of a rough landing there at the end, but we did the thing and... Oh, broken robot. Terrible. Terrible news. Nice. Oh, this looks like some type of battle space. Combat arena complete. Oh, okay, so we got some interesting new parts here. New contract ice cube is also interesting. But let's build the spinner. I want to see what this is all about. One of the final robots. That's a weird one. Okay, let's see. I want to see what these new parts that we just acquired actually describe as. Weights. Okay, weights are very useful. We also have hinges, which is pretty interesting. Hinges being the counterpart to bearings. Long connectors. I'm excited about long connectors. And then high-speed motor. Okay. It was Rocket League earlier, actually, Lo. So if I drive to this button, is it gonna give me something to fight? Oh. Okay, so presumably this is, so there is multiplayer in this game. So presumably the winner is the one that knocks the other one off. That would be super fun. That would be actually super interesting. So the spinner, very interesting. I like the fact that we have weights now to distribute. I think we may be able to use those to our advantage. So we got the tour guide, we got the tanker, and we got the tortoise. Let's come down here and see what we got going on. So we got a pizza delivery, we got another robot delivery. The stack of bricks seems very interesting. I think I want to keep unlocking things though, because we still have a fair amount of cash. I still don't know how I'm going to move that giant piece. But let's move this empty fuel tank. This might be a challenge. How big is the empty fuel tank? The robots are helping out. Love to see it. Okay, it's a big boy. I appreciate it, Alex. I appreciate it, as always. Yeah, this is a big one. Ooh, there's a tow hitch. Well, we gotta use that to our advantage. Let's build something new to interface with that. I don't think we want to use the hinge. Can I use my long connector that I just got? Oh yeah, all right, cool. Then we'll do something like this. Wait, this is actually not the way that we want to do this, is it? Because we want to... Where's a spacer? Grab one of these, and then we're gonna we can do that with another spacer, actually. That's nice. Just for aesthetic purposes, we'll use a spacer there into a... we're gonna use a servo there. Use a servo there. Into a, I guess, another right angle piece. And then I think this is our best for hooking that. And then how do we, I think we copy this, we delete that. We change that into one of those. And then we grab one of these fingers. And I think that's going to allow us to connect this like a trailer, and then we're just going to brute force it. I think I missed. Yeah, I did. I think the finger is getting in the way, unfortunately. Oh, and also we're not able to close it entirely. So let's copy this. Like so. Yeah, so now that'll be able to close, but this is probably not the thing that we want. I think that, yeah, that gets a nice closure. What am I gripping? Oh, I'm off by a little bit. I really want to get it to go through like that. Yes, okay, we are connected. That's as good as it gets. And then... what could possibly go wrong? Ho, ho, ho. I'm getting real Santa Claus vibes at the moment. We got a twist all the way around here. Oh. Can I get a twist at all? Looks extremely reasonable, right? Okay, now I think I'm just flailing. This is how flying works, obviously. Good news is it's an empty tank. Are we landing on this platform? Nope, under the platform. Okay, well. We're just gonna drive up this, and then we'll figure out what to do. We'll somersault here for good measure. Yes, the power of a good connection. All right, we'll slide in here, I think. Oh, all right. We have to be a little more careful about that, I guess. Uh-oh. I may have gotten myself locked in place, but that's okay. Because we've done 90% of the journey. We can just probably poke this thing into place at this point. This is going to be a little bit tricky just because we can't get behind it just to push. There we go. Nailed it. We have unlocked the blueprint for the tanker. And we have a new fuel tank to move. Let's look at what the tanker adds to the equation. Oh, the slidey thing. What is that part called? I'm very excited about that. Okay, so motorized joint. That sounds very exciting. And a rail slide. Okay, now things are getting interesting. Let's build this. So the rail slide is very slow, but we can lower this back. Oh, this is so cool. Right, so we just wish that moved a little faster. Oh, and then how long I have wanted this piece, right? So we get it in place and then we do that. So let's use the tanker. We're gonna create a modified version of the tanker. Oh, wait, and then what are these? Oh, grippy arms? Ooh. Okay, we got a lot of interesting things going on. I actually am really excited about this rail slide part. I'm not excited about how long it takes for it to go back and forth, but that's its only downside from my perspective. So if we take, let's take our flying vehicle and retrofit it with this, because I think it's perfectly designed for this. How do I get you to lay flat? Okay, I guess I use a 90 degree joint here. And then, I don't know about the grippy arms that they used. I think we can do better than those. But I do like the mechanical joint on the end here. And then I think I'm gonna copy that, get rid of that. We're gonna add Any chance that that plays well with that? That does not. No, I don't think that's what we're looking for. The thing that I would like to do is create that positive connection that we get. So I guess I'll just do one of those followed by that, and then we can do we could probably even do a 90 here. We have half spacers, right? Oh, it's so close. I'd like it perfectly close. How can we? We can do half spacer into 90. Into half spacer and see how. All right, that's pretty good, I think. Do we need anything else? We kind of want this further forward. So I think I'm going to try to. Try to loop something back around from here, from this point. So we need a 30 to cancel out the rotation like that. In fact, that doesn't even do it. Yeah, we would need one more to get it, and then that's way too tall. The wedge. What is the wedge is a 45, I think. So I don't think that helps our problem. So maybe for now, we just leave this here. Yeah, and we'll come back to that. And then I think we copy those because we're gonna need some attachment points, I think. For clamping. Is that? Kind of wish there was a button for a 90 degree rotation. I used to have spacers on here, didn't I? Yes. All right, let's try again. This is going to make our wheelbase even slightly wider, but I think it's okay. Okay, and then servos. Oh, those bump, which is a bummer. We can move the rocket thrusters out. I don't think that's going to have too negative an impact on things. I actually have no idea what that's going to do. For now, we can try something like that to see if we can lock it in place. And then the channels, this will be, if this is channel 4, this should be channel 4. And then we should swap the controls on that one. So now we have a grabber if we need it. We have a rail slide thing if we need it, although it is painfully slow. but then we have this articulating jaw that's going to be able to get a lot of work done. Okay, cool. So they gave us a fuel tank, so we should do it just to test out to see if we've done a good thing. I suspect that this thing is already handling very interestingly. Oh, the finger is in the way again. I think that's the problem. We need a better way to grip. What is... I'm just having a hard time reversing. Yes, I am. There we go. Now we rail slide it in. Oh my. Oh, this is a full fuel tank, so it's probably insanely heavy. Uh-oh. My grabber did not grab appropriately, but let's just see what happens here. Okay, this is a very heavy item. Let the record show. Wow. Like, I can't turn at all right now. Okay, let's try out the vehicle that they... I want to see if this one works better. Because it looks like... I guess we don't have to go that far. I'm going to put thrusters on it because... I mean, what is a world without thrusters? Gotta go fast, right? And then how do I want to do this? I think I will put them like here and here, just so that they're out of the way. I don't want to obstruct the design that they gifted me. I want to see if they know what they're doing. There we go. We'll just add those to make it speedy. So satisfying. And let's make sure that we've got... I don't like that they have these articulating separately, but I guess that's understandable. If they created this thing and it does not serve the purpose, I'm going to be very disappointed. That's what I was worried about. Yeah, those grippers are wildly ineffective. And seemingly important. All right, we'll keep going. The wide wheelbase is doing great work compared to our last attempt. Oh, we have to go over a lot of mountains with this. Okay, I have no forehead rocket. Bring the top hook all the way over. It's as far as it goes, I think. I mean, it goes that far, but I don't think that was the... Like, that's its max movement right there. All right. We have to go over a big mountain, so I'm going to return to the refinery, and we're going to go back to designing something with our much better flying vehicle. Because I'm not about to walk when I can fly. Well, I mean, the joint has more movement, Sliff, It's just we don't. Yeah, our design is so well set up for this, but we need to get better grabbers. So let's start again here. Now I think we can put these in place to try to counterbalance the fact that we're gonna have a bunch of weight on the back edge. That's my thinking. But it's the grabbing of the thing that I'm most curious about. So I think I'm gonna over-engineer the grabbing this time. Let's grab, speaking of which, let's grab our back assembly. And let's shift it back further and let's put in an anchor plate here. So we have something like that. Now, I generally like their... Oh, that's... Okay, I just had an idea. So we're going to put the motorized joint here. But instead of doing it the way that we were doing it before, I'm going to put a... Where are my 90s at? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7 looked right. No, 8. Okay. Do something like that. I'm going to use a hydraulic for the locking mechanism instead. So now... We're going to have that, and then we'll use the hydraulic to lock it in place. I think that's smart. Now, down here, I wanted to make a much more impressive grabbing situation. That's going to have to come one this way. That's okay, though. And we can do something like that. I think we'll go... actually, hold on. Let's rotate these like... Uh-oh, what did I just remove? Are those symmetrical? No, those are symmetrical. Okay, there we go. So let's do spacer, spacer. Then where are my 45 degreeers at? This one is wrong. Now we could use more hydraulics to improve the grabber situation. But I kind of like starting with that. Now, channel wise, these channel 4, channel 6, make them both channel 6. And let's just see if channel 6 now... Nope. We need to swap the controls on one of them. There we go. So now we got some grabbing power, I feel like. I like our locking mechanism. I put weights on the front to counteract what we have going on in the back. So let's try this out. I think our... Uh-oh. Oh, no, never mind. Lower the tow hook. Just trying to get a good... Okay, there we go. That's a good view to see. Bingo. Now we use this hydraulic to lock. Oh, that is gorgeous. All right. So I put the weights on the front. So far they're working not well. And also, can't help but feel like that did not quite work. But we're just gonna have to go with it, because that's the best we could do on this one. But yeah, this tank is much larger than expected. Oh boy. Oh boy. All right. We be flying. We be flying. Oh my gosh, I can't do anything right now. I can use this thruster. Okay, that at least gets us some. We're doing fine. We're doing a spiral ascent, which you don't see very often. Also, a spiral descent was immediately followed. Okay, I'm using the front thruster. I'm using just to keep us stuck to the ground while we drive. Let's see if we can get. Oh my gosh. This thing is so unwieldy. Okay, we need to. Oh yeah, it's a classic Mars First logistics strategy, Lo. I wouldn't expect you to know about it. This is going super well. The fact that we're making any progress at all is vaguely remarkable, but I think this mountain is about to best us to the point where I may. I feel like these are actually making it worse at the moment. Let's see if we can get it like lined up semi-straight, maybe. Okay, we are extremely stuck. I do seem to be upside down. You have a keen eye. All right, this failed. Excellent. Love to see it. We made it almost halfway. But these grabber arms didn't do anything. This thing is heavy. Now, mechanical joints. So I think mechanical joints completely remove the value of servos in most cases. They're probably really expensive though, right? 280 versus 160. They're not that much more expensive. And they're so much better. So we'll probably buy a bunch of those. But I'm trying to figure out what. Okay, let me look here. And we can go around the mountain range. That's probably the intention on this one. Mobetta. Noted. Okay, let's see if we can just load this a little more. A little more centered. Oh, look at that lock. We've got the tip of that underneath. That seems like it could only be good. And maybe if we drive as we're pulling, we can kind of get it centered. I think I'm also gonna try and get these guide arms into place. Yeah, so hopefully, are you gonna hit that and then you're gonna. See, that's the problem. I guess our guide arms need to be way further back to really help with this, but we've got it locked in, or we've got it on our on our setup. I actually... Okay, I'm going to take a totally new approach to this. I have an idea. I think there's an old item that we got that's going to be way better than all of this. And that is... the Humble Bearing. We have yet to use it. In fact, I don't even know where it is. I mean, I use it in my helicopter design, but we all know how well that went. Where is the bearing? Actually baffled? Oh, there it is. Okay. I'm just gonna try pulling it like a trailer. So I don't think there's any wrong approaches in this game. Also, what's going on with my trailer hook? Oh yeah, the bearing has... Yeah, the bearing is going to be interesting to get hooked initially, isn't it? The bearing is going to be tricky to get hooked, isn't it? Yes. We don't care about our approach, but like getting the bearing underneath the or getting the hook underneath is going to be a little tricky. I used to drive trailers with canoes on them, so I have the training. Uh-oh. There we go. Okay. So, I think pulling it like a trailer is going to be better than the plan that we originally had. I think flying on this one is just not what we're made for. But I think that, yeah, letting this thing fishtail around a little bit is not the end of the world. Unless we want to try flying now. The temptation to fly is high. The temptation was a trap. But I mean, I think we're still doing better than we were doing before. I mean, I can go over this mountain, right? Like, oh no. I should have made the tow hitch completely locked in place. Are we going to be able to get this back on? It's going to be a little tricky. I mean, it did land in kind of a nice position for this. Just what you always wanted, right, Lo? A little ill-advised flight. Yeah, this is... Alright, let's come up with a better design for locking it in place. And also... Oh, wait! Oh, I just had a genius idea. Hold on, we got brain stuff happening. So, we have the bearing, which is super cool. But what we can do is we can make it so that the bearing has a limited range of motion. So that it gives us... that little bit of flexibility without completely ruining everything. Right? So, like, if we put stanchions like this, now it can't go too far off to either side. I don't know if these weights are doing any good at all, so we'll get rid of that. Yeah, so now it can't. In fact, we can probably do like one more like that, and then we get like a nice range of motion without it being too off kilter. I'm so curious. I need to figure out what the high speed motor is for. So yeah, so now when we drive up to this, here we can raise that off the ground. So it's gonna flip back and forth, but see, now we're only getting like a 90 degree range of motion out of it, which is gonna be so much better. Oh no, I didn't handle the full close problem, which I think that will fix. There we go. So now that's gonna block. We've learned our lesson about that. That's going to block us from getting a good connection. So instead of doing that, I think we just toss a spacer and a 90. And I think now let's check how well that closes. Oh, with the rotation, the answer is not at all. Oh yeah, whatever locking mechanism we create needs to also be on the bearing. That makes more sense. Oh, you're in the way? I wonder, this is actually an interesting question. If I copy this, if I do a 90 instead, because it doesn't have the top edge to it. So maybe we'll be able to still build the thing that we want to build down there off of this. That wasn't. There we go. Nice. Okay, yeah, the clearances work there. Yeah, so this is going to be able to close all the way and make a full connection. And now all we need is, we no longer have a mount point for the bearing rotation stopper. But I think we can do that with, some of these. Right, because now they're gonna stop it rotating. It's not great, but like that's fine. I can work with that. Boom. Yeah, that happens sometimes, Lo. That is a thing. Okay, so let's see what. Oops. Oh no. Show me thrusters. There we go. Well, that seems even worse than it was with the weights. Maybe the weights were important on the front. Yeah, although that shambler wrecked me last time. Not to say that would happen to you, Lo, but oh boy. Okay, so the disadvantage of having it so that it can't fishtail fully is that we do have a bad time. We do have a bad time when we try to. When it hits that maximum. The time that I did it, Lo, on stream last time, the rewards for it are so important. And also, oh, this is a bad time. This seems like a bad place to be stuck. Oh, for yourself? That potentially too. Let's see. Reverse wheels. This is a cruel and unusual little nook and cranny that we've ended up in here. The dot item, the otherworldly fragments. The otherworldly fragments are insane. Oh, we might be onto something here. All right, the thing that we are onto is backtracking, but. And now we may be actually stuck. Yeah, with no up thrust, I think we're struck. We're stuck. It does get resisted a lot. That is true. Okay, we're gonna go the simple way here. I mean, not that it is simple, but we have spent enough time trying to get the flight working on this that I think it's time for us to do the runaround. Are you? If I pull forward a little bit, I think that might hook it. There, get the bulb through. Okay, so we're going to this waypoint, and the plan is to just use the thrusters to just keep ourselves moving forward, because the wheels are having a hard time keeping up. Probably wouldn't take it over a horn. I don't know. I think the horn is good also, but like when they both land, there is like no better damage in the game. This doesn't look like it's. I mean, do I just need to? All right, this is the one. As long as I don't. This is full of fuel, but it's clearly not the kind of fuel that's going to it's going to explode or anything like that. There we go. Nailed it. And at this point, flying over the potato marked landscape is probably best for business. But I think at this point we've got it. Oh my gosh. I was wondering if you could mess with the robots. Jackknife the trailer a little bit, trying to eke it out this way a bit. Come on. Okay. Oh, so close. This is non-trivial to get lined up, because we can't go straight at it, and we kind of have to back in. Oh, well, that's not good. Also, this construction item Oh, low. Coward. Well, I mean, Jester being coward is not the end of the world. They're far worse. Like having your leper roll coward. That's a real bummer. Although you don't have lepers yet, right? Still working on that one. Okay. And then I think, unfortunately, how close are we? Oh, are you kidding me? That's really close. We may actually be stuck here. Because I don't think we can actually push this backwards. Man, if I have to restart from here, that will be, okay, can I get you out of here? Okay, there we go. That's good. This might get it. There we go. Whew. All right, that was pain right there. But we built a rocket ship. New contract navigation data. Oh, I hope it unravels. Oh my gosh, what was that? Okay, that was just an opportunity to use the, to use that. Okay, so we have two more unlocks here. Are those the last two that we don't have blueprints for? No, there are four blueprints. This one looks very interesting. Okay, so we may want to do one of those here. Wait, this unlocks the rocket? Hold on a minute. We're doing navigation data. All right, we got